Next question comes from Jeff Ben, who's asked, how can you achieve the pop or bang when changing gear? Asking for a friend, sure, Ben. I don't believe you for a second. So the pop or bang on a gear change really is going to be quite specific to the type of gearbox you are using. This is something we normally associate with a dog engagement gearbox. And with a dog engagement gearbox, we don't need to use the clutch to change gear, and we also don't need to back off the throttle. So what we do need, though, is some way of momentarily interrupting the engine torque in order to unload the dogs and the gear that we're in so that the dog ring can move and engage in the next gear. So with that type of gearbox, generally we'll use either an ignition cut or a fuel cut, sometimes both. When we use the ignition cut, it's a little bit like an anti-lag strategy. Because we're cutting the ignition, normally this is only for maybe a period of 40 to maybe 60 milliseconds, so it's really brief. What happens is that unburned fuel makes its way into the exhaust system where it can combust, and that's where we get that pop on the upshift. So not something you're probably going to come across with a synchromesh normal style of road going gearbox, but you can still incorporate flat shift on those gearboxes. But the advantages in terms of the speed of shift really isn't there compared to a dog box anyway. That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.